Hello everyone, today we are going to learn about the types of sets. The sets mainly has four types. Okay, the first one is singleton set, which means it contains only single element, that is one element. If the set has zero element, then that set is called as null set or empty set. The another set is finite set, which means the set contains countable elements. Okay, and the last one is infinite set, that is the set containing uncountable elements. The set of natural number, the set of whole number, the set of integers, the set of rational numbers, and the set of real numbers are all the examples of infinite set, because the elements containing in that set are uncountable. Let's discuss the topic in briefly. First of all, consider the first set, that is singleton set. Now, what is singleton? Singleton means single element. Okay, the set consisting of only single element, that is one element, is called as singleton set. Let's have an example. A set, okay, A is the set of even prime number, means A has only such elements who are evenly prime, and we know that we have only one number that is evenly prime, and the number is 2. Therefore, A contains only one element, that is 2. Such type of sets are called as singleton set. The another set is empty set, which is also called as null set. Now, empty means nothing. Null means nothing. The set which does not contain any element, means there is not a single element, then that set is called as null set, and it can be represented as giving only curly brackets or by writing phi in it. Okay, this symbol is called phi. Consider the example. B is the set of all x such that this x is a natural number between 2 and 3. Now tell me, is there any natural number between 2 and 3? No. Therefore, we can't write any number in this curly bracket. So, it is the example of null set, and we can represent it using only curly brackets or by using phi. The another set is finite set. Finite set means the elements are countable. If a set is a null set, or a number of elements are limited and countable, means we can count them, such set are called as finite set. Let's consider an example. Here C is the set of all P, such that P is a number from 1 to 22 divisible by 4. Now the numbers between 1 to 22 which are divisible by 4, we can write them as 4, 8, 12, 16 and 20. All these numbers are lies between 1 to 22, and also all of them are divisible by 4, and we can count them as 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th and 5th. Such set are called as finite set. The last set is infinite set. Infinite means uncountable, the elements which cannot be count. Okay, such sets are called as infinite sets. And the example is natural number, whole number, integers, rational numbers, real numbers. All are the examples of infinite set. For better understanding, let's consider some examples. So, the first example is A, which is the set of all x such that this x belongs to n. N means natural number and x is an odd number. Now, solve this and check whether it is finite or infinite set. So, the x, okay, the variable x means it is a number which belongs to natural number and it is an odd number. So, we have so many numbers which are odd numbers, like 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 and up to so on. The numbers are uncountable, we cannot count them. So, the A is the set of infinite number. The another example is the set of B such that it contains all x such that x belongs to capital N, means x is a natural number, and also we have given one condition, that is 3x minus 1 equals to 0, means we have to find out the value of x such that this value must contain in natural number. For that, first of all, we solve this equation. Okay, the equation is 3x minus 1, which is equals to 0. First of all, find the value of x. Then decide whether it is finite or infinite. To finding the value, what we can do? We can simply transfer this minus 1 to the right hand side like this, and we will get the answer 3x equals to 1. After that, shift this 3 towards the RHS, and we will get the value of x, which is equals to 1 by 3. But what is the condition? X belongs to natural numbers, and we have got the answer 1 by 3, and this is not the natural number. So this value does not belongs to natural number. So we can't write this value in the set of N, that is our set is empty. We can't write any number in that set. Therefore, B is a finite set. We have seen the property, that is infinite set means a finite set means a set which consists a null set and also the numbers are countable. The another example is the set of C, which contains all x such that x belongs to natural number and x is divisible by 7. Means we need only such elements or such numbers that are divisible by 7 and belongs to this natural number. And we have so many numbers like that. Okay, we have the number 7, number 14, number 21. All these are divisible by 7 and also all these numbers belongs to this natural number. So the set is infinite set. Why this set is infinite set? As we can't stop this series, therefore the set is infinite set. The another example is the set of T such that it contains two elements A and B such that both the elements belongs to W. W means whole number, and the sum of these two number is equals to 9, means we need such numbers which belongs to this whole number. Means we can include 0 also, and the sum is equals to 9. Now 9 means only one digit number, therefore the numbers we are choosing are also one digit number, because if we choose the two digit number, then the number we get or the answer we will get is in the form of two digit number, and we need only 9, that is one digit number, so we consider the one digit numbers only. So first of all, what we will do, we will consider the pairs. Okay, we will assume the value of A and B ourselves, like 0 and 9, 1 and 8, 2 and 7, 3 and 6, 4 and 5, 5 and 4, 6 and 3, 7 and 2, 8 and 1, and 9 and 0. All these numbers are one digit number, and the sum of these digits in the pair are equals to 9. Therefore, the set is finite set. Why? Because we count the pairs. The another example is set of E such that all x belongs to integer and the square of the number is equals to 0. Now, integer means we can include 0, positive numbers and negative numbers also. And we have only two numbers whose square is 100, that is minus 10 and plus 10. And we can calculate or we can count our elements, that is first element and second element. Therefore, the set E is an infinite set. The last example is set of F such that it contains two elements A and B, and both the elements belongs to rational number. Okay, both the elements belongs to rational number, and the sum of these two number is equals to 0. Now, look at this. Rational number means it will include decimal numbers plus negative number plus positive numbers plus 0. And we have lots of pair whose addition is 11. Therefore, we cannot calculate them or we cannot count them. So the set of F is an infinite set. The last set is equal set. Equal means same. Okay. If two sets have the same element, then their two sets are called as equal set. Okay. Equal sets means if we have two sets, set A and set B are said to be equal if every element of set A means each and every element present in set A must present in the set B, and similarly the each element of set B must present in set A. If the condition is satisfied, then we can say that set A and set B are equal set. And symbolically it can be written as by using the sign of equal to. Let's clear it by using some examples. So in the first example, we have two sets. Okay, the first set is set A and second is set B. Now set A consists all the letters in the word listen, and set B contains all the letters in the word silent. By using listing method, we can write it as A consists of the element L, I, S, T, E and N, and set B consists the element S, I, L, E, N and T. Now compare these two sets. Okay, we have to compare these two sets. You can see the element L in the set A is also present in set B. Okay, the element I in the set A also present in the set B. Element S, element T, element E and element N all are present in B. The order may be changed, okay, but the condition is the elements are identical. You can see each and every element in the set A is present in the set B, and each and every element of set B is present in the set A. Therefore we can say that the set A and B are equal sets. Let's consider another example. We have two sets, okay, set A and set B. A contains x such that x equals to 2n. We have given an equation, and in this equation the n belongs to capital N, that is n is the natural number, and this lies between 0 to minus 10, including 10. Okay, therefore the set will be 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. We have 5 elements, that is 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. Also the set B consists an even numbers between 1 to 10, and the numbers are 2, 4, 6 and 8. Now compare these sets. Okay, the set A and set B, we can see that both the set contains same element, and therefore these sets are equal set. Consider another example. In set C, we have the element 1, 3, 5 and 7, and in set D, we have the element 2, 3, 5 and 7. Now compare both the sets. We can see the number 1 present in set C is missing in the another set, and similarly the number 2 present in the set D is missing in the set C. Therefore we can't say that set C and set D are equal. Therefore we can write it as by using this sign, which means set C and set D are not equal sets.